tonight, it was a statewide scheme that targeted desperate homeowners fighting to avoid foreclosure. The woman behind the scheme is behind bars, but KCRA 3's Mallory Hoff tells us the victims are still stuck with homes they can't sell.
Rafael Castillo was close to foreclosure on his Manteca home, so when a company called Save My Home said they could help, he signed up.
No, fueron a mi trabajo.
He believed that he was modifying his loan, or an investor was going to buy his loan.
Castillo says a representative from Save My Home pressured him to sign paperwork quickly.
It was like something rushed, you know. You have to come into the office. You have to sign. If you don't sign, they're going to foreclose on your house.
Castillo did sign and agreed to pay $10,000 in installments to Save My Home. But there were no investors. Instead, the paperwork put this woman, Jewel Hinkle's name, on the deed. Hinkle's had set up a network of companies with offices in Beverly Hills, Manteca, and Roseville, all part of a scheme to defraud desperate homeowners out of millions of dollars.
Part of Hinkle's scheme was to file bankruptcy in federal court, which stalled foreclosure proceedings, at least temporarily.
Hinkle's filed for bankruptcy over and over again for each of the houses. KCRA 3 has found 73 bankruptcy filings across the state, so many it caught the eye of federal prosecutors, who convicted Hinkle's on 16 counts of bankruptcy fraud and 8 counts of mail fraud.
This is certainly among the worst of these kind of cases that we've seen.
And now an even bigger problem still exists for her victims. Even though Hinkle's has been convicted, her victims cannot sell their homes because back when they signed all the paperwork, they were adding her name to the deed. And now each and every victim has to either ask Hinkle's to remove it voluntarily or hire a lawyer on their own and go to court and ask to have it removed.
So despite those avenues, they could lose their homes while they wait.
They could. I certainly hope they don't. You know, another factor is that a lot of the victims in this case were financially precarious to begin with. There's something like 1,300 victims out there. I'm not sure how many properties.
He decided he wanted a short sale, but now he can't even short sell because she's on the deed.
Sarah Martinez is Rafael Castillo's real estate agent. She's tried to convince Jewel Hinkle's to take her name off the deed, but Hinkle's refuses to sign the paperwork.
She tried to correct me and tell me that no, it does not. It's not supposed to read like this.
We came here to the Nevada County Correctional Facility hoping to speak with Jewel Hinkle's. She refused to talk to us.
Wagner's office is asking the court to order Hinkle's to sign over the deeds before she can be released from prison. But the feds are asking for the maximum sentence, 5 years, meaning Hinkle's could wait that long to sign the deeds over. And most of her victims don't have that long to wait.
I just want my life back. I just want her to sign the deed. As easy as it was to get her on the deed, you know, why isn't it that easy to get her off the deed?
In Stockton, Mallory Hoff, KCRA 3 News.
Now, the U.S. attorney is writing letters for victims explaining that Hinkle's name was put on their title as part of a fraud, but that still doesn't take her name off of the deed. Hinkle's will be sentenced at the end of March.